Go.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the qualifying session at simrace.org for tomorrow's 24-hour race of Nordschleife. I'm Shane Burke, and I'm joined by the one and only Wayne Reid.
Hello.
So yes, at the moment we are in the middle of qualifying, and at the moment, who is the quickest? Let's see, Daniel Hacker, which is no surprise, he's on a 7 minute 57, which is a lot quicker than a few months ago when we were last here. You're probably wondering why we're doing this race again, but which is a good question. We had a bit of difficulties last time out, but everyone luckily decided we'll do the race again, and this time it seems like we have no problems, so we should have a full 24-hour race without problems. Well, we hope, but last time out we were doing about 8 minutes 15 16s, so now we're under the 8 minute mark, so the mod has been changed a lot, and or unless people really improved, but so far so good. We haven't had any server failures, which isn't that common here, luckily. So we're watching one of the main cars championship, the GRL X Factor racing car. And yep. Go on.
Just kind of bump into you there. Bit of news on the last round at Silverstone, as any of you that watched it probably remember that there was a bit of an issue at the end of the race due to a server issue that the administration had. We did the last hour and a half of the race, but only did the last hour because there was a glitch that had been overseen. It was then voted on by the team owners to decide whether they wished to run Silverstone again or keep the results. The decision was made to keep the results and clarify that. So the results for Silverstone stood as how they finished.
Yep, and then points for the championship have been counted, and at the moment it is pretty close for the lead up to the championship with Independence Racer GT2. Yeah, it's so close, with Witchwood only about 10 or something points behind. It's really close, with GRL XF STR Racing 1 only about 10 points also behind, so it's really close. And I think 3 Wide Motorsport today, or for tomorrow's race, and All-Star Racing Team 2 are really ones to watch out for, as there's not that much pressure on them. They can just focus on the race and go out and try win.
We've also got a penalty times change for the ring. This is basically, I'll try and do this as cleverly as I can, is the penalty times. It's basically you get the pit stop time of 3 minutes, time to drive a full lap with damaged car, which they've classified as 17 minutes. So again, if you get a disconnect or press escape right at the start of the lap, the worst case scenario is for a penalty time of 3 minutes plus 17 equaling 20 minutes. The normal time to drive a lap is an average of 8 minutes 30, and then you would need to go and do your stop, so that'll add a minute for that. And in total you lose the 20 minus the 8.30 minus the 1 equals 10 minutes 30. So it's a little more than a lap. If you had to drive a full lap with a damaged car again, it would have taken way more time. So pretty much if you get a disconnect or you escape through the fact that your car's too damaged to drive back, you'll lose a lap. It's the overall time that you'll lose.
Exactly, and quick notice, or not quick notice, but just to let people know, if they have any questions or want a shout out, follow me on Twitter at TheRealSB, or on our Facebook page, which is www.facebook.com/broadcastteam. Also, we aren't running in this race, sadly, just we are all focused basically on Le Mans, which is about 2 months away or something like that. End of June, I believe.
Yep, end of June for the 7th edition of the simrace.org 24 hours of Le Mans, with some good features coming to that. With I do believe, if it's still to be done, featuring the rain plugin, So, which is going to be fantastic, but hell, it was discussed, the idea beyond running it, that we'll be, they've managed to sync up with a weather system server of some kind that'll enable whatever it's doing in real life at Le Mans at the time will be what we get in game. So, which is, I'm looking forward to it, but a lot of teams are wanting in, and obviously only certain places available, so we're all pushing like mad and trying to get the times up there. If you're interested in doing so, you can go to simracing.org and register there and download your sim sync. The choices of cars is LMP1, GT1 and GT2. And then it's, if you've not raced in the previous, the GT3 Championship, which we're doing this weekend, there's six qualifying rounds to do. At the end of the six qualifying rounds, I think it's the sort of the fastest times that you manage to do will sort of adequate whether you're going to likely to get a place. So, which is a fair system, you know, everyone's on the same basis. It's only teams that are guaranteed a place are the ones that have participated in at least four rounds of the GT3 Multileague Championship, which I think is also fair, you know, they've shown their worth there, so it's, you know, come and join what's going to be a fantastic race of 24 hours all-out racing at Le Mans.
Yeah, it's going to be fantastic, and it's a big enough grid with about 50 cars allowed to race, so, you know, it's going to be fantastic racing, hopefully, and hopefully not that many crashes, especially with the rain, and, you know, people like myself, I've never driven the rain yet, so it's going to be a new experience.
Yeah, I mean, I've driven it a good few times on GTR2, but I'm yet to do it on R-Factor. I mean, there's a league I'm running in that uses their own plug-in, but as of yet, they haven't enabled it, like, hasn't been in the races that we've been in. It just keeps being dry, so I know it's going to come at some point, but I think it's going to bring a whole new aspect to R-Factor, so that's for certain. It's something
exactly
that's tremendous. I mean, I had a test round Le Mans on GTR2 the other day, the exact same track layout with the BMW GTR, and it was scary. It was it certainly was with the same setup, it really did took me three or four laps to find my feet properly to get a half decent pace out, so you know, you never know, hopefully maybe in the next season of this that the organisation will decide to use the rain plug-in in the GT3 multi-league again, which would be fantastic, because I certainly think whether I would be able to stay on the track or not is a different story, but just have a go at running around the ring on R-Factor in the wet would certainly push the button to me. I don't know about yourself.
Yeah, I think Le Mans even itself is a daunting challenge in the rain. I'm kind of same as yourself, just been on GTR games messing in the rain, but that's it. I don't know what R Factor is like. It could be just completely different, so ooh, kinda nervous, but it will be a fantastic race to watch, and at the moment me and Wayne will be not competing together, which is a bit strange, but yeah,
copped out for the P1.
It'd be interesting.
They're gonna get it handed to them.
Oh, well, according to some people, I won't be quick enough for the testing we've done so far.
This is the thing.
It's good enough.
Yeah, we've got plenty of time for practicing. I'll just give you a quick rundown of the top 10. At the minute, we've got first place is Daniel Hacker. Second place is Alex Piccolo. Third is Daniel Scorfenza. Fourth is Maximilian. Fifth is Akeem Kruse. Sixth is Marius Burt. Seventh is Kevin Mass. Eighth is Mishish Paniski, I think it is. I do apologise if I've just murdered your name. Ninth is Alex Rambo, and 10th is Julian Seedbedil. Trying to see, we got notice there, Mr. Ronnie Hannell, that races for the independent sim racer team down in 16th, so I'm wondering whether they've not decided to go for their all-out lap just yet. Maybe keeping their cards to their chest. We know, you know, if you watched the previous time we was here in November, I think it was, Mr. Rocket Ronnie became quite a celebrity with some of his Well, when I really were to awesome. It was a mega overtaking manoeuvres. It was something to behold. So we're kind of hoping he's going to give us a show to watch tomorrow and Sunday.
Yep, and the gap to the leader is 1/10, which is freaking crazy. Yeah, so if they, I'm expecting them to go at least a second quicker by the end of tonight. So yeah, that's pretty crazy how quick they're going. At the moment, the track is 27 degrees. So yeah, it's still pretty warm.
It's all looking good. I'm just going to get my other timing up, so bear with me a second.
Yep.
I know I've got this folder for this somewhere.
Marius Birch, one of the title contenders this weekend, and I've driven with him around this track in a different league for a 24-hour race, so and from what I've seen in testing and in the race we've done, he's unbelievable, so I'm expecting him to be up front this weekend.
Yeah, I think it's going to be the usual kind of teams at the front there again. I mean, could be wrong, but I think it'd be the usual suspect. I think obviously the ones to watch is Independent Sim Racer. You got, well, it was Witchwood, wasn't it? Was doing really well the
yep.
last few rounds as well. And then you've got X Factor Team 1, Turn 3, which we know through previous rounds have sort of been there or thereabouts. Definitely X Factor Team Racing 1. A definite team to watch out for overall victory. I don't know so much about pole position, whether Carsten and his fellow racers in that team there are going to pull it off, because I do believe that they're running quite a substantial amount of success ballast from the last round, so whether they can put themselves up there or not is a different story, but I don't think they'll be far off it.
Interesting is GRL XF STR Racing 1 car is in third place, and they have two teammates in 8 and 9, so I'm expecting team orders if the cars are in 8 and 9 position. If they're ahead, I'm expecting them to pull over during the race, but be interesting to see, will they actually pull over? But if they're good sports, I'm guessing they will.
Yeah, I mean, you generally find most of the teams that are in the Liga quite nice to each other as a general rule of thumb. You don't get too much. I mean, we know a few drivers have been over ambitious in qualifying at the start of the race. We know one of those isn't no longer part of the league. We shouldn't be struggling too much for people moving. Plus, obviously, with a nice long lap, you shouldn't have an excuse not to find clear track, really.
Exactly, as we watch Kevin Mass now in this lovely coloured Audi. Really stands out from the crowd, actually. A bit sloppy though, a bit sideways and missing apexes, over pushing too much. So we got to Mr. Rambo. Never seen this guy around here, so. And I would tell you the team he's with, but we're having a bit of difficulties with that, so my apologies.
There's Rambo, one of the X Factor guys, I think.
Nope.
Don't quote me on it, though.
I'm actually, by looking at the car, I'm certain it's it's an association, I think. I probably am wrong, but sure. And close enough, it's a Ferrari 458. That's all I can tell you.
We do apologise, this routine, I mean, it's our live timing, it's only giving us the driver names, but I'm sorting that out at the minute.
Yeah, so fully on the limit at the moment as we switch to a LSF racer car. Pretty nice looking Audi, looks like it's golden white, which is actually a pretty epic colour scheme, and it's a bit more yellow than I thought, but anyways, so lovely looking Audi. And I think what we've learned in the last few race meetings, even though these cars are meant to be pretty even, I think the Audi is pretty much dominating.
Yeah, it certainly seems the car to be. As most
exactly.
races have gone. I mean, I remember it was all of the X-Factor guys for the ring last time was running round in the Alpinas, whereas I think it's only one of those is doing so now. So it's they all seem to switch to the Audi.
Yep, as a, oh, my favourite team from, oh, a good while ago, the SRC and SKC, Perkin Minecraft.
Fucking Minecraft, I think it is, isn't it? it's going to be another one of those weekends.
Yep, bad, or back to the messed up English and German again, so, yes, my apologies, but, yeah, I don't know, even I have no excuse, so...
No, I've always got excuses.
Oh, me?
Yeah. But I think we need excuses. we'll have to think of something. I mean, let alone not getting the German bits right. It's sort of, I'll struggle enough with English. Oh, that was a bit of information.
No,
I read this, but if Mr. Enger can confirm it for us, that Sim Racing for Poland have signed up for this race. So, they did it last time, they've not done any races in between, but I see a sign up that had their name on it, so if Mr. Singer can confirm whether they have been granted permission to join or not, because obviously we know that they was the team to beat.
Exactly, so yeah, it'd be pretty good to see them back now. This is an all-star racing car, it could be, it mightn't be, and it's probably not, but anyways, it's another Audi.
Now, let's see if this will let me connect. Please work.
good old reliable technology for us. Never, ever working. here's Rocky. No, that's Mr. Hanel in the Independence Sim Racer car. Kind of.
Yeah. Is
he surprised
to
see him that low down?
Because I know he's.
Let's see.
And they're running two teams again in this event. Let's see if.
We are watching Hanel Ronnie
Senior.
Hanel at the moment. Which.
Yeah,
Manuel
he is in
Hanel
17th position. Yep. So, good luck to them.
And here's the other car. Oh, I've accidentally found a Simrace in Poland car.
Oh, I've got my R-Factor monitor working.
Nah, perfect.
But, it still doesn't give me the team.
What will we do?
Kill Lutz. I think that's the plan. we should
exactly.
Fly over there and
take his
coffee
machine
with rat poison. You know, he puts all this pressure on us. You know, the €1,000 an hour we get just isn't enough. You know, I mean, we turned down contracts last week to do Sky. You know, that was offering us £275,000 a year, and we said no. We're just too kind to Mr. Enger. But we can give
as
you
we
split
watch,
sectors
I think
now.
It's the only... Ooh, that's good.
Yeah, we can give you splits. I mean, as in timing, I'm not doing the splits, I'll never get back up again.
Yep.
It seems, who's the closest? Well, I'll do it this way. Daniel, Mr. Hacker in Sector 1, is 160.942, and Alex is 166.08. So he's actually quicker.
Very close.
But he's losing it. In sector, he's losing just a smidge over a second in sector 2. And a couple of temps in sector 3. But that's wrong.
No. We are watching, I think, is the only Jaguar in the field. So, kind of a surprise as the big bulky car, but they seem to be able to go quick enough in it, since they kind of won the race last time out, but it wasn't really officially a race because of the problems the server had and stuff like that, but we think it's all fixed now.
I'm going to see if I can find a new job.
Yes.
Simracing.org, if I can find the qualifying results for the last time we was here. To see what the times were. Now, where would they be?
I think I might even have it on our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/broadcast team.
We've got... here we go. Qualifying results for 24 hours of Nordschleife. Right. Well, we had Daniel Hacker was on pole. Carsten was second. Max Milliard was third. But what I want is the times. This isn't giving me times, it's just giving me positions. If I scroll down, maybe it does.
Pretty certain 8:15 or 16 was pole position. I'm probably wrong.
Here we had Ronnie was fifth. Daniel Scorfenza was fourth. Sim Racing for Poland in the Jaguar, which was... they are in it then. That's that name I murdered, Mr. Pesnicki, which is Russian. Polish, I do beg your pardon. that's why I'm murdering it. They're in, so they're sixth position, they qualified last time, so in me live timing. Where is his name? So where is he? There he is, eighth position. So at the minute he's two places beyond where they qualified last time of visiting. If you're listening, Mr. Enger, if you're out there, is there any chance you can give us the times that the drivers ran? Yeah, one more money. Because I'm unable to find the times, but I can find the positions. I'm sure the times used to be here. There's a VCR file, but that's no good because that's a replay file. I'd have to load that into my R-Factor to review that. We'd be very much obliged if you're listening. Probably not. Probably enjoying watching television or something. Listening to us rabbiting on, but...
I think it'd be a good idea if we go what time we start at tomorrow, which I believe is 2 PM UK time?
I'll soon tell, yep. Just give me one tickety-boo. Because
tickety-boo! Kangaroo.
When my website loads, come on, please speed up. It seems like I've got your internet this evening. Thanks very much.
Yep, no, so you'll be more stressed
sim
and
racing for Poland
if
you are watching in their Angry Birds car. I don't know how long you've been watching it for. Probably far too long showing on the cameras this evening. Well, if you're going to do a lap, I think
that'll
you're best
give the viewers
going on board for a lap.
Yep. Well, we've been on board and off board for a bit, so we'll go back on board since you want an on board, and he's 1.3
well,
off in the middle
with somebody.
Sector.
You know, you can go on board with someone. If we can find someone near the start of the lap, I've got a vague idea of gearing because most of the cars are most similar gears for most corners. I couldn't pronounce the corner names. I do beg your pardon for that. It's, I'm not very good with German.
Helpful news. wait. I've got some information, Mr. Wayne. I found out why everyone is really, really quick. Mr. Daniel Faber from Tree Wide Motorsport has told me we're using a different version of the track. I think we're using the VLN version, which is slightly shorter. So it explains why we have much quicker times. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I don't know how we didn't cop that on, but anyways.
No. Right, here we go. We're bibbidi-bidi. I can tell you the times now, because my speed has done something. No, am I looking in the wrong place again? Oh, for goodness sake. Sheesh. Website's very slow today.
Be quiet for a split second and just checking something.
Right, maybe this is the page I want. Ah, here we go. Right. The race times will be... Race starts at 3 p.m. CET. So that's 2 o'clock UK. We'll run for 24 hours. The race length in minutes is 1,440. The time scale is on 1. And the server start time is 3 p.m. So in game it will be 3 p.m. It will start. And I do, if I remember correctly, it starts to get dark quite quick round here. Around about the between 5 and half past 5. So we should be getting into the dusky sort of hours quite early on.
Yep.
So those are your times for tomorrow to join us. We'll be broadcasting live. And I do believe our German colleagues will be running side by side with us as well. So if you're wishing to listen in German, you can join our German colleagues on their stream. We'll advertise that on Facebook, which will get posted so you know which channels we're on. But we're generally 1 and 2 or 1 and 3, depending where we get put. So please feel free to come and join us.
Yep. Just to let you know, the Simrace Poland car was moved up to 5th place there, so a really good lap from them, which leaves them how much off the pace? Let's see. He's 1.2 off, so a 10th actually in the last sector, so.
And
but still big
Ronnie's
gap to
jumped
lead.
To 9th as well. From 16th
yeah,
to 9th, so they're
places.
Opening up the taps. I do
and
believe
currently the slowest
that Mr. Scorfenza is Carsten's teammate, I think. Let me just go back.
I shall check. No, he drives for RSR Gaming. So he's Italian. And I just killed that.
Yeah, and that's not Italian. So you're not very good at Rossi, are you? So you should leave the Valentino Rossi impressions to us pros. Mr. Enger
yeah,
enjoys
sorry.
More Valentino Rossi. Just quickly turn my light on because I can't see my keyboard very well.
Hey, also for tomorrow, we have many, many topics to go through if the racing gets a bit dull, which... We are hoping it won't and expecting it won't get dull, but we have topics from like the World Endurance Championship opener at Silverstone, ELMS, Blank Pond with like 60 GT3s on the grid at Monza and many, many more. So make sure you join us for God knows what.
Yep, and post your questions up and we'll try our best to answer them if we can. If you've got any snippets, the things that are going on, please feel free to throw us a line on our Facebook page or on Shane's Twitter page, which is at the real SB in it, I do believe. I don't subscribe to the Twitter sphere. I am on there, but I find it about as useful as an ashtray on a motorcycle, if I'm honest. So I can't even remember what my name is on there. It's I gave up with Twitter after about an hour of usage. I tend to find that Facebook's more my area of expertise. You can also send us private messages in simracing.org if you're a member on there. Obviously my name's Wayne Reed and then Shane Burke. So you can contact us via that system as well.
Yep.
Please feel free to do so.
Yeah,
we've
because
got that's making a move.
Well, we have the leader in the pit. We have Marius Burt in the pit. Alex Piccolo in the pit. So we have basically three of the top five in the pits.
Yeah, we're getting a good spread for the drivers that are around at the minute. I'm watching the map at the minute, and there's some decent gaps. I think they're the ones that are going to struggle for. I mean, they are far enough apart that they shouldn't affect each other, although with the positions that they are time-wise, the key may well catch Ulrich. He's in position 7th and Ulrich is 24th. So, other than that, there's a good bit of space between the ones that are running, other than that, so there shouldn't be much of a hold-up. I think Akeem's going to catch him pretty quick here. He seems to have pulled about 10 seconds in on that little bit there. So it's one good thing in qualifying, you do get a nice bit of gappage between drivers if you're all sensible. It's just a bit of a doobry in the race when you get cars that are separated by 30 to 40 seconds. For commentators, it makes our job very difficult.
It does indeed. Just to let you know, the gap to the leader is under 0.3 seconds, so Alex Piccolo knocked off about 0.6 seconds in that lap, and around 100-something-odd corners. Impressive to be only 0.3 off. And third place is the RSR gaming car, 0.9 off, so bit of a gap with championship contender Marius Burt in fourth place, 1 second off, so fairly good. Let's see, any other interesting names through the field? No big names on the bottom of the field, really, that I notice. Seems like the big boys are up top as usual.
We'll go for there. Let's try. That's strange. I think we've had a driver change and my timing hasn't updated. Because according to my timing, that should be Mr. Hannell Sr. driving that at the minute. But it's not.
Nope. In the BMW Z4, which is not that popular either, but thankfully someone's racing it.
I think this is the only two teams that race it. It's the independent teams.
And they also use a Bosch 911, I believe, and they're the only team that uses that as well, so thankfully someone's used different cars than all Audis. And once again, that hay bale is knocked over at the chicane, which shouldn't be touched, but seems like it's getting rammed out of the way every lap.
What else have we got? Run down the last few positions. Julian Sieberdil's now in 11th. We've got Stefan Knits in 12th. Rico Kistin Misha is 13th. Matt Newman, 14th. Mark Park, I think that's pronounced, is 15th. It's Mr. Hannell Sr. in 16th, but I don't believe it's him actually in the vehicle now. Jerry Elbs is 17th. David Pachisky is 18th. Dustin Levy is 19th. Marcus Dumillier is 20th. Ulif Ness is 21st. Conard Barr is 22nd. Ulrich Nulting is 23rd. And Marcel Offermans is 24th, and 25th position is Partek Yaskiski, I think that's his. So Mr. Offermans there, he's the talented man behind the rejoin plug-in. if anyone wants to know. That's the man that's coded it. So this is all these rejoin events are courtesy of his skill beyond a keyboard.
Yeah, actually, I was just watching a program there, BBC, James May, one of his programs.
Man,
and
man.
An interesting fact is if you stay a minute, or if you're on the radio and you stay quiet for 1 minute, you get fined $25,000. And whoa, crash. That's a big one. Will he flip it? He does flip it into the ground. He must be dead. Oh, wait.
Replay
that. No, wait. I'm getting lag or something.
No, I'm doing a replay, hopefully. Let's see.
Ah, okay. So what he do? Just came out sideways, corrected it, which
car got
threw him
the back in.
Over.
Oh dear. That'll be a return to the pits for them then.
That's
just one thing is with this track. It's a lot of places where you can get the car tends to go light quite a lot, and a lot of corners around here, which can play havoc.
Exactly, but
purposes as well.
Oh, big pain. But I'm just looking for a second. Luckily, we don't get fined $25,000 every time we go quiet.
No, I mean, some people
we'd
actually
so
pay
hammered.
Us that do shut up. we're on 1 hour and 30 minutes remaining of qualifying, which was a 3 hour session. It was extended to double time due to the length of lap. So with obviously the quickest time being 7 minutes 57, so you're looking at an average time of around 8 minutes 4. So with having to do your out lap and then your timed lap, the organisation decided to put the qualifying time up to a 3 hour session for this event.
Yep, as for people that usually use this track, probably wondering why not take the short version and then do your lap, but the timing line had to be moved as we're watching a Mercedes SLS, which looks like it's another Simracing Poland car, and it is, so good luck to them guys using Mercedes. I cannot drive one, don't understand how they go around corners, but yeah, luckily they're using two completely different cars, which is pretty actually epic.
Yeah, two cars we don't normally see.
Yeah, and I...
Whoa, nice big bit of air there. Lovely stuff.
Yeah, we see on the back, save the ring. As we'll probably have a big long talk about that tomorrow, and hopefully we'll get someone from that organisation to come in and tell us how that's going.
Yeah, last I was reading, it's still up for sale, the track now. I do believe it. There was four investors interested. Don't know where we are with that at the minute, but I do believe that was the story I last read on their Facebook page.
Whoa.
So you can find info on that on Facebook/Save the Ring. It's a very worthy cause, so please go and show your support to save this wonderful and historic track from being closed and being gone forever.
Maybe such a pity, but I think we'll save that conversation for tomorrow, or we'll have nothing to talk about.
I'll think of something, Mr. Burke.
I hope so.
One of your insights into human behaviour.
Big lock up there into the second last corner, and... Ooh, what's this lap time looking like? Not looking too bad.
There we go, let's go on board, hopefully they'll stay out for another lap, we have a nice ride round. And you can see the speed there, in kilometres, he's given up that lap, so,
Well, actually, for people that are looking at the timing and wondering why it's still going, I believe that's timing from a sim, or independent sim racer car, so,
yes,
little glitch.
It doesn't seem to be, some reason it's not giving us the timing. Let me just have a little look, see What driver are we on board with? Do we know?
No idea.
Oh, that's helpful.
That's lovely, jubbly.
Because I can't pick him out, boy.
Ooh,
I'm wondering if that's
big twitch under braking.
Let's try. Oh, and get the right button. No.
Oh,
but
well,
we can go with these because they're just about to go on a lap by the looks of it. So we'll jump inside and have a ride round. See the track magnificence from the driver's eye point. As many of you know, this league runs on the emphasis that it's professional. As such, it's forced cockpit view, which is fantastic as far as I'm concerned. You know, if you want to race cars, you know, you wouldn't race a real-life racing car. Sat in the bonnet, would you, with your steering wheel, so I'll do it in a sim gun, you know. This is how it should be. It splits the men from the boys, as they say.
Exactly. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good model of the car inside a F1 type wheel. Yeah, it's pretty epic looking. Great mod.
I know one thing. The setup's mega round here. This car's sticking like some freaking rails.
Yeah, it's something that I can't get my head around with these cars. Just something
I can't even get
doesn't...
an F1 car around here to stick like this is.
Yeah, I've had a GT2 set up for a spiker and it was pretty goddamn awful. Yes, Marius Bert drove the B word off it and put it in the top 10 somehow, so yeah, it must have been that bad, but yeah, it's pretty difficult to get a setup around here though, as you have so many corners, but then that really, really long straight down the back of the track, so you don't know what wing to run, really.
I tend to, with most things, I tend to run a medium wing, because I think that you've got one really long straight, which, the way this mod is, doesn't matter, the gearing only goes so far, so you're all going to redline anyway, which is always the case, and then you've got a couple of squirts in between. You know, you're looking at, what, maybe 87% corners around here, and quite a few of them are Mickey Mouse corners, which is what we refer to as being fiddly diddly things that are an absolute pain in the bum. So I tend to go for a medium downforce setup with other things that I tweak on the cars, which I'm not telling people. secrets are secrets. I mean, I'm the slowest fast guy on most occasions, but my setups are my setups. But I've been finding I'm getting quicker and quicker using the Motec system, which I imagine quite a few of these teams will be using, which would kind of probably lead you to see why this setup's as good as it is, because that Motec, through how far I've got with it, I've managed to knock 7 seconds off of a setup that I've been using for the last 2 years through using Motec, so it's certainly a worthwhile piece of software to try and learn. It's difficult, but when you're gaining times like that, I think it's worth the effort.
Yep. I might as well give us a bit of people outside my window screaming. That's great. I will go out and strangle them kids any minute now. And a dog. And the cat that's annoying it.
Have you got your window open, have you?
Nope, but somehow there's kid and dog and everything outside my window as I'm commentating, as usual. But anyways, that's just my luck. I could just go on about my bad luck. Like, I buy a brand new gaming computer and it's supposed to be pretty freaking epic, but no.
You broke it.
I can't have broke it. I turned it on, I go on R Factor and it drops like crazy. Actually,
I just think it's you. I mean, when I had it here, it was running sweet as a peach.
If anyone is watching or knows anything about a computer, if anyone can actually help me or had the experience, I can run DX9, everything full graphics. I get like nearly 300 FPS, which is pretty good. But then when I come across like a few cars or any buildings or nighttime, it goes down like by 100 FPS or more, which is pretty diabolical. And even when I run DX7, it still does the exact same thing, so a bit confusing, a bit stupid.
A bad workman always blames his tools, and we've just Mr. Pinniskic jumped to fourth position. Yeah, he's moved up significantly. And we've got Daniel Hacker still in first, Alex Piccolo in second, Daniel Scoffenza in third. Pisniski is 4th, Marius Burt is in 5th, Maximilian is in 6th position, Thomas Packer is 7th, 8th is Kevin Mass, 9th is Ronnie Hannell, and 10th is Mark Park. So,
I'm going to strangle my dog. Luckily I don't have dogs on my window for the 24 hours tomorrow, as I'll be different venue, but I'm seriously getting annoyed at my dog. But also, I just got a tweet that we could be lagging a bit, so I'm investigating that now, and hopefully it's only his internet and not a server problem or something like that, so...
We need to hook up to the broadcast, so we'll let you do that. Come back to the end of the lap now, sector 3. Come around the last carousel, just at the next corner. And then we have a slight kink coming up. And then another kink to the right. And then a right corner after that. And then it's foot down, gears all the way up. Put your seatbelt on because I'm going to try something down the back straight. Are we lagging on the broadcast?
No, I can actually watch it. Usually I lag when I try to do that, but it works perfect, so...
So it's not off then, so... It's, try refreshing your browser. F5 for most browsers. And if you're using Internet Explorer, that probably solve half your problems if you use either Firefox, or the best one is Google Chrome, so... Try those, or try a... reboot your system, maybe that will rectify your issues.
Yep. So let's get back to the action as we enter.
Yeah, it was on an outlap. So we missed an outlap. That's some bleeding outlap, man. Woohoo, your daddy. I've got the right buttons here. No, that's not it. There we go. So let's have a. Let's try Dooby Dooby.
Will we do a top or run through top 10?
I've just done that.
Oh well, okay. Sorry about that.
Yeah, and, she's falling asleep again.
I was checking, did the broadcast work, so it makes use anyways.
They all say that, coming out with your excuses.
Yeah, my excuse book is becoming very thin now. Kind of running out of them.
You know, you just can't get the star.
I know. Actually, interesting, is Simracer for Holland racing this weekend? Let me see. Can I scroll down? I think Marcel Offermans is a Simracer for Holland driver. I shall quickly check if everyone doesn't mind. That's not it.
Nope.
There we go. Is that a Simracer for Holland's livery? It is indeed.
And they're in the Vetti this week.
Ooh.
Normally they finally changed from Ford GT.
Which was pretty awful. As experience with it from testing for Daytona, it was pretty awful. It was not bad handling, but it drank fuel like a thirsty Irishman in a bar. And no, people, I'm not slagging Irish people, as I'm Irish. I'm just stating a fact.
as Mr. Hacker going on to start his timed lap.
Yep. Expecting a quick lap. Locks up in the first corner.
Hey.
Comes out of it beautiful.
She even got the daytime running lights on that as well. Look. See him? Never cool. Noticed that before.
No. Yeah, so I'm gonna put a bet on. I will bet 50 cents that this lap will be a second quicker.
50 what? Francs?
Cents. Cents.
50 cents. 50 pence.
Ah, yeah. 50 pence. Okie dokie. Don't know how I'll give that money to you, but either way, this will go a second quicker than he's done last time. So, Mr. Hacker, you better not crash.
So you think that he's going to go faster than he did before, yeah?
Yep, a second quicker, which would mean he'd have to do, let's see.
He's a 56.9. He'd have to do a 756.9 to go a second quicker.
Okey dokey. So track temperature is 26.9. And what have you found?
This bon appetit. I guess you eat chips. I think you can hear me.
Oh no! I lose 50 pence.
It's peanut M&M's. I'm a bit peckish. Oh, I'm shaking. Low blood sugar and all that. Not good for me.
No, but one thing that is good for you is you win 50 pence as Daniel spun into a wall.
Yay!
You buy some M&M's now.
Right, well, we've got 1 hour 15 remaining. I'm going to predict that the finishing results of qualifying, I'm going to say, is Daniel Scorfenza for pole, Alex in second, and Daniel third.
Actually, speaking of Daniel, who was in third position in the RSR, he's... You noticed I've not pronounced the second name.
No, Scorfenza. No, Sebastian has asked me if I can pass him a thing like M&M. That's anyone wondering, that's Mr. Sebastian Ruhn, and he's one of the drivers. He's Rocket Ronnie's teammate, so if he fancies coming in and giving us a little nutter, it'd be fantastic. He's a man in the know, very talented, awesome man with setups. So
is indeed
come in and give us a little nutter and tell us how things are going. It'd be very much appreciated.
And top three are within 3/10 of each other, and second and third is only a few hundredths apart from each other. So
I'm going to write my prediction down. So what did I say? It's Daniel for pole. Daniel for pole, and then Alex second, and Daniel in third. Alright, what's your prediction for your top three?
Ooh, Alex Piccolo on pole.
Yeah, so Alex. Yep.
Daniel Hacker second.
Yep.
And Marius Burt in third.
Ooh.
Take a bit of a risk.
I'll do that every time I get out of bed. I'll sound like a bowl of snap, crackle and pop when I get up.
No.
What am I doing? Right. Ooh, lovely.
Ooh, a bit wide.
Mr. Sebastian is going to come and give us a little interview in a few minutes' time. So, something for interesting for you all to tune in for and get some info from one of the drivers. That'd be something to look forward to. And your top stints to tap.
I didn't make the mistake first. Yes.
No, the top 10 is at the minute is Daniel Hacker is first, Alex Piccolo in second, Daniel Scorfenza in third, Mr. Paniski is fourth, Marius Burt is fifth, Maximilian is sixth, Thomas Packett is seventh, Kevin Mass is eighth, Ronnie Hannell in ninth, and Mark Park, if it's how you pronounce his name, is tenth. So, pretty much everything's more or less where it was. Alex isn't getting any closer though, is he? Seems to be stalemate between those two at the present time. What are we like for car changing? Shane's not bothering. Good stuff. Let me let's try. There we go. Let's have a car we haven't had for a while.
I guessed wrong earlier on. I thought this was a All-Star, but it's a RTM racing car, so my apologies on that.
If anyone's looking for a job in broadcasting, there's a position opening up shortly as a co-commentator due to Shane being demoted to radio work for CBeebies, which is a children's television channel. Although then again, no saying that, with the language you come out with, you'd probably be about as welcome as Jimmy Savile.
Oh. That was a low blow.
Slip of the tongue. We're looking at laps.
I think I'll just quit now. Go home.
We've had Daniel's done 9. Alex has done 8. Daniel's done 8. Mr. Paniski done 12. Marius is on 11. It looks like Maximilian's the most at the minute on 18 laps. Thomas Packer's 9.
No, Kevin, you are wrong.
12. No, I'm on about in the top 10. Ronnie Hannell is 12. Mart is 9. Then we go down to the next. Alex is 13. Julian is 10. Stefan 16. Rico's 21. Mech is 13. Manuel Hannell 9th, that's Mr. Rocket Ronnie Hannell's dad. Where are we? We got Jerry is on 10. Patrick is 14. Sven is 15. Sven, I'm sure that's the man I do my other commentating for. Dustin is 14, Marcus is 14, Olef is 21, Connard is 17, Ulrich is 9. So who's done the least out of all of those? Who's done the So it seems Daniel's the one at the minute that needs the less to do a quicker time, because he's in third, and he's... Oh no, it's Alex, he's on 8. How many of those are completed time laps, I wouldn't be able to tell you. This just gives you laps complete, so whether they're, you know, like, whether they're all fast. And we've just had a position jump. Philip Knowles just gone up to 14th position. So let's have a look. Who's on their quickest times? Position 7's having a good old fight, which is Thomas Packer, which is one of the X Factor Racing boys, I do believe. If my memory serves me.
Teammate to the car we're watching.
Right, let's have a... What's the what's All-Star Racing number? Do you know who one of their drivers is? What position are they in?
Wait. We have to watch Mr. Daniel, or not Daniel, Marius Burt, he's on a very, very quick lap. He's going quicker than the leader in first and second sectors, so...
Six tenths up, yes.
It didn't change
You've got Marius in
car.
third, so at least you get one in the top three, which pushes one of mine out.
I would change car. Oh, wait, change car now. There we go. Marius brought on an absolute flyer down the back straight now. Will he come in the top three? Please do.
Well, you don't want him going up in a tree.
Well,
You said in the top three, you know, more like top three, I think would be a better place for him to be. You know, top of a tree, you're not going to go very
yeah,
fast up
tree.
there.
No, might find some
No?
squirrels though.
Yes. Three plus three
Squirrel
equals
stew.
six. Yeah,
Well done.
that's woodland maths. There we go. That's what happens when you go logging.
Lot of smoke. Oh wait, see,
Cool! Jeez,
that's
he's using all
close.
the track there. I definitely saw a puff of smoke come up there as the rear tire caught. He's gone into first, and
Whoa,
he's 1.1
by a
quicker.
second.
Jehovah's Witnesses.
Oh,
That's a quick lap. So that is a 7:56.8. So,
amazing.
it was, yes, that's the problem I've got there, isn't it? Excuse me.
So, is he on a quick lap or not? Let me see.
So, none of us have predicted Alex to be third yet, but you've got Maris in the top three and I haven't, so that gives you 1 point so far.
Booyah.
So, anyone else want to join in with the predictions? You can buzz us a line on Twitter at the, or sit at the Real SB, or on our Facebook page at facebook.com/broadcastteam, and give us your prediction for your top three out of any of the drivers, any position goes, and we'll see what comes out the end of it. We might be able to get you a signed photograph of Mr. Lutzinger having a cup of coffee or something, perhaps, as a reward. As he's informed us today, he's got 2 kilos of coffee for the 24 hours, so which is mega substantial. Although saying that, I've got a friend of mine who's a massive coffee nut. He goes for about 1 kilo every 2 hours, so I don't actually know how people do it and still sleep.
What?
Yeah, he goes to Edinburgh every few months and he buys some sort of coffee it is. I think we've been joined by Sebastian.
Hello, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, and yeah, I'm also very interested in the laps as you are. We're commentating, so yeah, it's really thrilling. I haven't expected that it will be so close in the first position like it is today. So yeah, that's really thrilling, and yeah, very very nice time from Marius.
Breathtaking time that, wasn't it? I don't
Yeah.
quite know where he found that. So, how's your preparation going for the race? What sort of where are you aiming to finish?
I have to say, yeah, our aim is to reach the position we are having now. We need
Ninth.
position 9, and then in this case, which would can win the race, but we will still be the champion of the series. So P9 is we have to reach this if which would win the race. So yeah.
It's all to, you haven't got masses to lose as such. You haven't got a push for victory, whereas which would do. So it's you've got the upper hand.
Yeah, that's right. But if you have read in the forum, we are now back with big penalties for rejoining, and so maybe if you got the worst case for rejoin, then you have to wait over 20 minutes and you lose 13 minutes, and that's a lot. And in that case, you have no chance to win positions without bad luck of the other teams. So the first thing is it's the best way is if you can take the race without any rejoining.
That's going to be a big ask.
Yeah.
And, although you don't tend to have many disconnection problems, do you, with your teams?
Yeah, we had our problems at the first Nordschleife event. And it was very lucky for us that this race was cancelled, and we had also big problems or bad luck on Daytona, where we only got, I don't know, position 16 or something like that. It was not a good position. So it's sometimes only luck if you got no failure during the race. If you're having problems during the driver swap or something like that, you cannot do anything about it. We know what we have to prepare, and if something going wrong, so that's not our fault. So, yeah, but it's for all teams the same. And sometimes you have the luck and you don't get any bugs from Air Factor, or sometimes you get one. So.
Yeah, we've all been down that road with our factor and its wonderful glitches. I happened upon one the other day in a race I was in DRMs, and coming onto the start finish straight, and my R factor glitched and the car appeared in front of me, and I smacked him straight into the pit wall. Ended his race, which was unfortunate for him. Well, you know, fortunate for me, it didn't affect my car, but you know, I didn't feel too good on their part. I don't even think, like you say, it's going to be a race of attrition, isn't it? You know, how many disconnects are likely to take place, and also we know with the dreaded 12-hour thing, as me and you have discussed in the past, that we get into the unknown server territory after the 12-hour mark.
We have to wait what happened, and also Lutz made in my opinion a good choice that he say now if we get a mismatch on the server, we will stop the race and restart the server, and this should help us to prevent the big bugs, like a car is beamed from the pits to the track, or something I don't know, in a virtual world on the track. Sometimes they are so stupid bugs, and normally they happened after mismatches, and I hope will help us to have less problems, and also the second I hope that we have on Sunday a finished result and not have to to calculate once again which is the right positions for the teams. That was really awful in Silverstone, and it's very bad if you after Silverstone, as we won the race, and we weren't lucky happy about it, because we don't know what's happening. We had a good performance, but then you Lutz said, yeah, maybe we have to cancel the race again, and so it was awful. So I hope that the timing and all will work, and we will see a clear timing at the end of the race.
Yeah, so overall with your season, do you think that you're pleased where you are, or, you know, improvements that you'd like to see for next season and bits and pieces?
It's difficult to say. I think it's the first point is it's Marcel turn or work. Maybe he can make some improvements on the tool, but there are also some cases with air factor bugs where he cannot do anything if they happen. So that's there's nothing to prevent the errors, or to calculate it out of the timing or something like that. We have to leave it like that. So I don't know if there are if there is a chance for a new series for better performance. I don't know. This you have to ask Marcel about it.
Yeah, I was just about thinking there, do you think that for the new season, whether the driver swaps in R-Factor 2 will be ready, and maybe that they could move the series over to R-Factor 2?
But at the moment, I don't see R-Factor 2 as an opportunity for a new sim for endurance races. Not at the moment. I think it's more buggy than R-Factor 1. I think we have to wait at least a year if this is working, and also the performance of R-Factor 2 is not enough for a crit with more than 30 cars.
That's an interesting thought.
maybe Assetto Corsa can be the next one, but yeah, it's also at the moment I think you can call it better status, and we have to wait and see. Yeah, maybe it can be our new sim. I'm hoping we don't have to wait any longer, because I have to say I don't want to race again in a new series with Air Factor 1, but I'm sure we have to do it.
Yeah, we're just also been joined by Max as well.
Hey guys!
How are you doing?
Exhausted.
Exhausted.
And a bit shocked what times the other teams are going.
Yeah, I must admit the lap of Marius kind of blew me and Shane away a bit.
Totally insane.
Yep.
But it's the thing, when you get the second lap totally right, you can't go that fast. Because you got the advantage in the first sector of, I think, 1 second at least. And when you then can drive quite stable through sector 2 and 3, you can make it for 57 if you're fast enough. I'm not fast enough for that.
No, you're not the only one. I'll be about 20 minutes going around here in these things. that's providing I managed to not crash at any point.
Yeah. I had enough now. I'm happy with my 59.0, and I'm looking forward to the race, so I think team performance is more important than the performance of one driver.
Yeah, I mean, it's something that I mean, a lot of us was discussing a few of the ones that are trying out for Le Mans, that there's a lot of focusing on lap times and things, and obviously with endurance racing, qualifying doesn't really mean anything. You know, you can
exactly.
You can start a good few places back and make that time up. It's like you say, it's more down to what you can achieve as a team as opposed to as a driver on his own.
That's true. A driver, the pace of a driver on its own just matters in sprint races, like where you have no driver swaps whatsoever.
So do you feel that you're completely ready for the race, like you're happy with car set up and
bits and pieces? I'm not sure if I'm completely ready because I haven't had that much time for preparation. But I think I'm able to drive quite fast and stable. And I'm pretty optimistic for the race, so I think it's going when everything is fine with the servers and the rejoin plugin, I think we're going to have a great race.
And we've just had Daniel Skorfenz has just jumped to second position as well.
With or without cutting?
Well, I don't know, he's just done a 57.9, so he's just very barely over a second beyond Marius. So, you'd know more than I would with that.
Well, but I shouldn't talk about cutting because I'm not sure if my lap was clean, I have to admit it, but I think it was clean.
Yeah, it's a very, although saying that, it's a hard track to cut on because obviously some of the curbs are about 27 feet in the air, so... to it and land in a tree once you've hit it.
Oh, some curbs are like in a perfect place where the car stays stable when you take the curb, and when you take the normal corner the car gets a bit wobbly.
Yes, it's seems a trait in every car you drive around on these circuits with the ring.
This car's on this
four
track.
Four or five curbs you can get at.
I think this mod on this track is a bit special.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the mod, I must admit, through racing at Silverstone was probably the worst sim race I've ever had in almost 7 years. I was absolutely ashamed of myself, to be honest. It was I don't understand what the issue was, because in practice I was running a reasonable pace, and then it came to the race, so I took over from Nico and was doing okay-ish for... Yeah, probably up to the midway point of my first stop coming up, and then my lap time just dropped off, so I stopped, got fresh tyres and stuff, and then pretty much every lap for 15 laps I was spinning off somewhere, and I've never had that in all the years I've been sim racing. It was a damn disgrace. I just don't like the mod.
Oh no, no, I think the mod is very special, the handling. I think in reality GT3 cars handle a bit different. I don't know it in person, but I think they handle a bit different. But
yeah, they do feel a bit strange.
But well, it's a challenge to drive those cars fast, so it's easy to
drive at a
normal pace, but be like alien speedish. You have to practice a lot and work a lot on the setup.
Yeah, you need Sebastian. You just set up master.
The telemetry guy.
Yeah, he's going to be the man I'm going to be chewing the ear off for my my Motec training. He's the man in the know for Motec.
Well, I never used telemetry. I will never use it because I won't understand it.
Yeah, see, I was off that philosophy, and I downloaded it and installed it, and there's like a YouTube video on the bloaties, so it's like 2 hours long. And you get your file at the end of it, and you load it up into Motec, and it's just all different coloured lines and scribbles, and you're like, where am I supposed to make any sense of any of that? But you kind of do in the end, and then you notice, like, you change one thing on the car, and then you look at your Motec again, and it'll kind of tell you exactly what the car's done on that lap, and... You know which direction you're going in. If you know what you're doing and you can go from that lot, like Sebastian, and I imagine probably a few other of the teams and drivers use it. It's, well, I mean, like I say, I managed to find 7 seconds with using Motec, so it's a valuable piece of software. I just wished it was a bit easier for us mundane normal types to be able to you know, unlock Sebastian, who's got an O level in engineering, it seems.
Well, yeah. I don't understand all of the setup at all, so when it comes to dampers, I'm like, well, dampers, they do something, but I have no idea what they're doing exactly.
Yeah, I was of that. I know. I think it's the slow bump reacts to driver inputs, and fast bump reacts to what the track's doing. If I'm right, so I think Sebastian knows better, but I think that's how I remember being told it once.
Yeah, and that's the two important points. That's absolutely right, and that's all you have to know.
And I think when you get the dampers right, you can find another 1 second in the setup.
Yeah.
At Nordschleife, because of the track length.
I think on the Nordschleife, I think this is true, but it's more important for consistency in lap times. And if you have a stable setup which handles all
Carson's
the...
just nerfed it into the wall, sorry.
No problem.
That was a big crash. You know, carry on.
which handles all the stint the same, and maybe you have the chance with a good setup to reduce the tire wear. That's the important things. I don't think that a setup on Silverstone or shorter tracks lead to much bigger lap times, faster lap times.
That could be right. Maybe it's like increasing the drive comfort, and that's
it was Carsten.
Yeah,
massive impact. And it's not the Schwedenkreuz.
No, but I had a crash at that corner today also.
But he turned his Audi into one of the world's most expensive lawnmowers.
And again. my car was stuck in the map when I crashed, so my back wheels were hanging in the air, so I couldn't go forward or backwards, so I just pressed escape.
One place I've noticed with a bump that really improves is Le Mans, with the chicanes down the Mulsanne straight, and I think it's the Ford chicanes at the end of the lap. If you get your bump setting right for that, you can monster the curves. And it doesn't unsettle the car at all. It's amazing the time you can find around there with a decent bump setup.
Well, I have to pay Sebastian some money to make our car setup. For Le Mans.
You can't do that, because if you do that, then I've got to pay him to make mine.
Yeah. You can't afford it.
You'll be a millionaire.
Believe me, I can afford it if I want.
I'll swap you, Sebastian, a bag of peanut M&M's for a setup.
Talking about food, I'm going to get myself some food.
Soup, right. Where are we? Here we go, it's Mr. Packer. Yeah, no, it is. It's, like you say, I think the biggest thing, it's one area we're always looking into, is tyre wear. I think we're getting bad, something going on here. The cars are messing about. I don't quite know what's happened there. But yeah, tire wear is definitely a weird server crash.
Ronnie did another fast lap, and he was 8/10 of a second faster than his Formula fastest lap time, and I'm really surprised, because I said to him today before the qualifying, if you are reaching 8.1, then you have a very, very good lap, and after his 8 minutes 1 seconds, and he said it was a perfect lap for him. So, and we did some changes on the setup, and maybe it worked. But the position is still the same.
have to say that you have got 80 kilos of penalty weight.
No, 100.
Okay, even worse, so...
That's got to be stinging round here, innit? It's got to be what worth? That's got to be about 3 or 4 seconds a lap, innit? Surely round here.
Okay, you have to say Marius has 20 kilograms, Daniele's Confienza, I think he has zero. Daniel Hake has 30. Alex Piccolo has 40. Marcier Pasnicki has 20. Carsten Wilhelm has 40. Thomas Pache, 0. Kevin Maas, 0. And then Ronnie with 100. And the 100 kilos, I think they are around 6 till 7 seconds a lap, which you are slower.
Yeah,
we've got 100 kilos.
Over 40 minutes remaining. And my prediction for pole's not working out at all. It's supposed to be, my prediction is Daniel Scorfenza for pole, I think I said. Then Alex Piccolo for second, and then Daniel Hacker third. And Shane's got Alex Piccolo for pole, Daniel Hacker for second, and Maris Burt third. So he gets a point at the minute, but I get naffle. So somebody needs to give Mr. Hacker a kick up the bum, because he's costing me money here. So this is what happens, you know. I'll try and bet on horses and end up backing a donkey. Not to say that I'm faster than he is, because I'm nowhere near it, but I'm just kind of stipulating the point that he's not where I want him to be. Yeah, I mean, generally when I'm doing laps around the Nordschleife, from my lap times are measured on calendar months, you know. Yeah, never going an onboard round here with Shane. Do an onboard lap with Shane round here. We did a race before Christmas in the Porsche Super Cup cars, and I decided while I was having a cigarette break that I'd jump on board with Mr. Shane Burke. And it's the first time in my life I've actually been scared doing sim racing.
It
was a change of pants after spending 8 minutes in the car with him, after he drove up a mountain that he found in the middle of nowhere. On his way round to the first carousel somewhere, he come round the corner and just went up this embankment. That was fun.
That was scary as hell. I had to change my chair.
Yeah,
what's
the money? Yeah.
I think you got something wrong in the downforce. Yeah.
No, it's
put the downforce upside down.
Shane's a noob at sim racing when it comes to, if you're not pushing 199%, then you're not going fast enough, and it causes
to
overpush the mark somewhat.
Just a bit.
Yeah, see, you know the term tyre management? Shane looks as that as, yeah, I've got tyres and I can manage. I'll manage the tyres. You know, he's the kind of driver, as long as he's still got the wheel rims left, he'll race round them. Yeah, it's a shame your tyres have fell off. Oh, well, you know, I'm still lapping reasonably quick.
That's typical.
You've got the Vin Diesel or sim racing, aren't you? If it's got wheels and an engine, you'll have a go.
Exactly. Ah, that race wasn't too bad for me. I would have won it by a minute if my computer didn't have a fit, but on the very last lap, which was very gay. But anyways, I kept
the
wheels
the
on
computer.
It for once.
Always the computer.
My antivirus kicked up.
That was a bug in that mob though, man. That's that poor Super Cup mob. And there was 20 of us and 15 of us had crashed the desktops. Although I was relieved when mine did, because it was a 2 hour and 40 minute race. And I made the fatal error, because I didn't want to get fatigued, I drank 2 bottles of Lucozade before the race started. And got to 2 hours in, and nature had taken its course, and I was on the verge of wet myself. It was so when my PC decided to flip out, I was actually relieved in more ways than one. Yeah, I was disappointed because I was running in 8th place, so I would have had a good finish if I'd have managed to get to the end, but such is life, I suppose, you know, it's, these things are sent to test us. I think that's why Lutz doesn't race, you know. He's announced that he's got 2 kilos of coffee for 2 days, so I'm thinking many toilet trips are heading Mr. Enya's direction. Does anyone actually race Lutz ever?
What?
Has anyone actually raced Lutz?
Raced
what?
Have you raced him, you know, like in sim racing? Has anyone been in a race with Mr. Lutzinger?
No.
Nope, I'm not. Don't think so.
No, I've never even seen him race.
I know him since 2008, which was my first event of him, and at that time he wasn't driving. There were only a few stories, and that he has a wheel, and but I never have see him racing. So don't know.
He's a secret racer. I reckon I know what his racing name is. I reckon it's Carsten Willem.
or maybe he's too fast for us, and he hasn't find any right opponents for him, so he decided to talk about it.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It's either that, or it's maybe that he gets that stressed with running the servers and everything, and it's a pain to race as well. I know that feeling. It's the downside you get, that you get into sim race and then you think, yeah, I'd like to run something. And then you start running it and then you realise you spend more time doing all the stuff that needs doing than actually doing any racing. You tend not to get a chance to race your own stuff. It seems to be a no-win situation. He does do a good job of running stuff, I must admit. Probably one of the best run leagues there is. He keeps you locked.
Are you guys doing Le Mans actually?
Who, me?
Well, anyone.
I'm thinking about some of my teammates are going to drive there. I have to see if I'm at home and if I want to and etc. So I'm going to decide that in 1 week or so.
Okie dokie.
But I'm gonna go to my teammates again, so we see you tomorrow, I think.
Thank you for coming in, and good
see
luck
tomorrow.
To the race if we don't speak to you before.
Okay, fine. Thanks. Have a nice evening.
And you.
Yeah, and I will go to my teammates too, and bon appetit again for your peanuts.
I've got a chocolate chip cookie now.
Ah, okay.
I'm starving.
That's interesting too.
It's the hours we have to work for Lutz, you see. We don't get time to get any food. He works us to the bone. You want to see my clothes? They're like rags.
Okay, yes. Yeah. I think, I hope I find the time during the race. Sometimes it's difficult. Depends on what's happening on the track, or maybe if some of the drivers tired and we are only three drivers, so it's. It's hard because normally we are only two in the channel and one is taking a rest, and then it's difficult to come to the stream. But I think I hope I will find the time.
Yeah, well, looking forward to it, and thank you for coming in and giving us an insight from the team's perspective, and the best of luck.
Yeah, thanks.
Good luck. So, we have Mr. Jordan Weeks with us, who's been waiting here for a long, long time. Poor lad.
Far too
long. How are you?
I am fine. How are you guys?
No, I'm super. Apart from the fact I'm starving to death. But
yeah, we're complaining we don't get paid enough, so, yeah.
I think you should complain.
Need more money.
I think you should complain. Yeah. Ask for a pay rise.
Yeah. Yeah, €1,000 a day isn't enough.
Yeah.
Anywho, Jordan, you don't compete in this league as you suck too much. What do you think of the drivers?
Feel the burn. You're gonna pay for that one.
Yeah, he'll crash the car Le Mans on purpose now.
If you crash out a car at Le Mans, I will absolutely go crazy on you. I will go.
You're not the only one.
The easiest way to beat him, Shane, or wind him up, is get the Toyota A86 mob and take him round Brands Hatch.
Oh God!
It took him 4 laps to overtake me round there.
Oh my God! And we're sharing the same car as well. Okay.
Yeah. Good luck with that, Jordan.
Yeah.
You're better off sacking him and just having him as team principal.
Well,
because that car will end up in a tree at some point in the 24 hours.
Well,
nice of you, though.
Hopefully, that shouldn't happen since I managed to get Phoenix Motorsports to help the team out in the near future.
So, which I'm thankful for.
Yep. But then. Of course, I won't be driving for them. I'll be have to drive with Shane and Nico. But...
See, Nico's alright, but Shane's erratic. He's got speed.
I'm not that bad.
He likes to drive cars up cliffs and stuff.
You're saying you're not that bad? I thought Irish drivers are always bad.
Oh, thanks, man. Some teammate you are.
Some teammate, yeah.
Right, quick rundown, we've got 30 minutes remaining and still your top positions remain as Maris Burton Pole, Daniel Scorpenza in second, Daniel Hacker in third, Alex Piccolo.
Wait, sorry,
in
I'm
fourth.
Trying to run through the cars.
Wait.
I can't see who's in fifth because my lifetime and thinks it's the Invisible Man. So
I will tell you now. It's Zink Pasniki in the Sim Racing Poland car.
Right, yeah, well he's gone invisible, must be stealth mode. And then we got Maximilian in 6th position, Thomas Packer 7th, Kevin Mass is 8th, Ronnie Hannell 9th, and we got a new person in 10th, Marcin Bizgwoski, I think that is, in 10th position there. There you go. So, we've been on
lovely
this car for 2 hours. Whoa, that was a cool shot. Nice. How's the All-Star Racing, boys and girls, getting them?
Let's see, we haven't heard from them in a while, and they're still in the pits, so definitely winning the race for staying in the pits longest.
Yeah, I know, it's like watching Formula 1 free practice. Sit up all night watching them, spend the first hour, they do an installation, that, and get back out the car again. It's like, what's the point? Oh, hang on,
yep.
Getting graphical glitches here, I've got... Mercedes is nose diving into the track.
Nose diving cars.
This is what happened on the race department broadcast. After it was like 19 hours, I tuned in about 3 in the morning. And all the cars was driving half in the track, half out of it.
Okay.
Yeah, it was entertaining to watch. Because you had to recognise the car by the rear lights because you couldn't see the front of it. Yeah, it was all good stuff. It was like a spotter's guide to geekiness. I think, that was the night when Simon Smith got food poisoning, I do believe.
Oh, Simon.
Yeah, he disappeared. He done his takeaway bingo thing. And I can't think what it was now. I think it was some sort of curry or something he had. Then he ate it and then... He just disappeared and everyone was like messaging him left, right and centre, where are you? And he'd more or less passed out in the bathroom. He was in there for about 5 or 6 hours, I think.
Dreaming about
spewing his guts up, where he said he was sitting on the toilet and throwing up in the sink at the same time. So it sounded quite nice, you know. That's when you know you got a bad food poisoning when you're going both ends at the same time.
Oh, Carson is with us.
Oh, we got a celebrity in the house.
Hi.
I reckon, Carson, I actually believe that your real name is Lutzanger. We've discovered, because no one's never seen Lutz racing, so what I think is it's you're actually him. He just keeps it
yes,
secret.
Yes, yes,
and he's got a voice
just,
box
just
so
like
he sounds
that.
Like you.
It's just like that.
So, how's your qualifying going?
Not really good. Because if you look on the timetable, it's only P6, and Daniel is on P3, and I think it's somewhat disappointing for us, because we thought we would be a bit faster, but also we didn't think that so many other cars would be so fast.
Yeah, I mean, I must admit, I was kind of expecting to see you up further than you are, but is it because you're carrying a lot of success ballast?
Yeah, we have 40 kilos, but it's a bit like I can't really drive with kilos. I think it sounds like an excuse, I know, but it's just like that. I'm not really able to drive with kilos, and yeah.
No, nothing wrong with driver excuses. Shane's got hundreds of them. You have to borrow his book.
Yeah, I've written a book, sold about five.
I mean, he's had everything to rabbits, low-flying helicopters and everything. So do you kind of, do you feel that the car's ready to go for the race, or do you think that there'll be a setup change between now and tomorrow afternoon?
Well, I think the race setup is there, so I think that's okay, but I think I have to get over the qualifying first before I think of the race. And but I also didn't have that much time to do training, because in the last 2 weeks I had some exams, and I had to do this, and then it was warm outside, and we did some barbecue, and that's what it was a bit bad, because the training went to the background. So maybe with more training I would be on 1 or 2 seconds faster, but I think what Mario's bad did, this 56 lap, I'm speechless.
Yeah, you're not the only one. It kind of blew us away when he posted that one up. It come from nowhere, that. And do you reckon that they can carry that pace through the race, or do you think that's just out-and-out quali pace?
No, I don't really know. In Silverstone, they were also really fast in qualifying, but in the race, we were kind of the same pace, so maybe they have less kilos this one again, and I think a bit faster they should be, but I think we are not that bad in the race than we are in qualifying. I hope so.
It seems Thomas Packer's got the fastest last sector that he did on lap 4. So it's a pity, really, they don't give you a combined time through the quickest sectors to see what the actual fastest lap could be around it. But I'll bet it's down into like 55 if you combined all the fastest splits. The worrying thing is Maris Burt will probably go faster. You watch, he'll do a 56.4 or something.
Yeah.
It's the sort of thing what happens.
Earlier on, we were joking a bit about Mario's bed and said this lap was only a bluff, and then he drives a 49 in the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, we don't know. What's happening to the cars, Mr. Cameraman?
Oh, sorry, I was looking at the timing for a second. Let's see who's. It's actually like F1 qualifying, there is no one going out.
Yeah, what about the back guys at the back? Well, we know Carson's not racing, you Wally. He's in here talking to us. Oh, dear, stick it on your car, Carson, mate, if you pull out the garage.
I think our car will stay in the garage. It's already, the girls are there, and they are They are cleaning it up a bit, though, so the car looks
nice. Yeah, I see. Well, watching them bend over to get the sponge, are you? The old brolly dollies.
Yeah, we have to do some regeneration, if you know what I mean.
So I think that's what happened to Nico when we was in the DRMs. We qualified, there's me and him in first and second for Division 2. Then the start of the race comes, standing start. I got a belt in start, letting the clutch out, and Nico decided that he was going to have a blonde moment and not engage first gear, so I swiftly had to jump straight to brakes and ended up in sixth position. Yeah, he just didn't move, he just sat there. I was like, what's going on? Everyone's driving past, and then he says after the race, I forgot to engage first gear, so yeah, that helps.
Some other guy managed it a few years ago not to engage the first gear and not neutral, but he engaged reverse gear. and he was in P1. He was in P1 and I was in P3. That was not nice. At first I thought you were going super fast, you're going forward and he's coming back, must have been like warp speed. At first I thought, damn, I had a good start, but then I noticed it.
Yeah, it's not fun. No, I've had it before where someone gets a bit over eager and spins off the line and wipes about six people out, or like the GP3 race I did 2 weeks ago. They're using launch control because it seems that some people can't start the cars properly, and I hate launch control. And it was sort of, everything was going fine until one person, something happened to their car, so everyone around him broke, and then someone decided to mount the rear of my car, knocking my rear wing off, which was good, and didn't even manage to go 4 foot before I ended up in the pit lane. I seem to attract bad luck. Now, if everyone didn't do qualifying and I can start on pole, I reckon I'd have an half-decent race. I don't mind being passed, I just want to do a race where I'm not getting wiped out by someone. I blame Shane, I was doing alright till I met him. It's bad luck. And you're supposed to be Irish. You know, Irish people are supposed to bring good luck. Now, I'm going to drive for X Factor Racing. I'll get good luck with them, I can start winning races, then Carson can train me up.
I have Jordan Weeks training me, so all good.
Yeah, good luck with that,
Jordan. Maybe you'll get the place in our rookie team.
Well, I wouldn't actually say no to that if it means me going faster.
Oh, I can
learn. There's one thing you should maybe learn, to speak German.
Well, that's a definite no-go. I can learn to go faster, but learning to speak German, I think, I've probably got more chance of winning Le Mans this year than learning to speak German.
Actually, I wouldn't mind trying to learn German.
No, I know how to say one swear word, what Lewis was teaching us earlier.
Guten Tag, yeah.
Yeah, Guten Tag and Danke.
Wait, is it? there's hardly any. There's hardly any activity going out on track at the moment.
Nope.
That's because Carson's in here. See, what we need, Carson, won't you? Quickly dump your kilos out the boot when no one's looking. Get one of your brolly dollies to swift it out the boot there. Go around and stick it on pole.
I tried, but they used super glue. I wasn't able to get them out.
See, it's going to be a funny race because obviously we had Ronnie overtaking all three of your X Factor cars the first time we was here, but he's in ninth. It's I'm wondering what we're going to have for a start. But then saying that, you normally identify with Marius, Daniel, and the other Daniel, Mr. Hacker and Mr. Piccolo. It can be quite entertaining at the start. But then Mr. Piccolo has been known to be over-eager at times as well, hasn't he? So that could lead to some shenanigans, which is all good for us.
Yeah, but concerning Ronnie, I certainly thought he would be a bit faster.
That's what they're aiming for. It's Sebastian came in and he said that they're aiming for ninth as well as in the race. Apparently, if they finish ninth and Wychwood win, they still win. Independents will still win the championship. So they need to finish ninth or higher, and they've got it. So it comes down to disconnects. If you know, if they get a disconnect,
We want to win the race because if Wychwood finishes sixth or worse, then we would get on second place on the championship. But I think it's a bit unrealistic if you look on the timetable now.
Yeah, but then you never know. I mean, it's like I was saying earlier, qualifying's one thing, but a race is another, and you know, it's 24-hour race, anything can happen.
Especially when it comes to the Nordschleife. The track here, the reason why it's called the Green Hell is it's extremely difficult track. I think most teams out there would concentrate on keeping the car safe and getting it to the end.
What was that all about?
No, but I think in the past it was like that, but now it's like a 24-hour sprint. Even though
what
it's the Nordschleife.
Is anyone else? What the hell's that all about?
What happened?
He's driving around the track in reverse. He pulled a handbrake turn and then went backwards for ages and then spun it back round again. What was that all about?
Maybe the exhaust was getting too hot.
Yeah, also I thought my PC had flicked out for a minute. It was like the minis I got from my Scare Electric, where they got a special thing in the bottom of them, and you flick the power on, so they spin round, and you can go around the track the other way. It was like one of them. Bizarre. I'm even wondering whether the organisation has something to say with that one. We've got 15 minutes remaining, and everything's still as it was. I think that's where it's going to finish. But yeah, you can carry on with your talk now. Now I've had my exciting moment there.
But as you said, Carsten, you're saying that it's a 24-hour sprint race. So, when, in my opinion, normally it's just 24 hours of trying to stay as safe as possible. So can you tell me why you say it's a 24-hour sprint race?
Yeah, because if you really want, okay, there I think there are two possibilities, and the one, as you said, is try to keep the car on track and be safe, and I think there should be a relatively good result possible, but I think if you really want to be fast and to maybe control the race, so to say, you have to drive fast. And I think those drivers, Daniel Hake, Marius Bett, and they have the class to drive fast and safe. So I think this should be possible.
Yeah, it's something we've noticed in previous races. There's a few of you guys, yourself included, that seem to do outstanding lap times for 2 hours solidly and not make a single mistake, which quite annoys me because I can't manage it for 6 laps.
two hours are only 12 laps here.
Well, yeah, that's true. It's still a big ask. I don't know how you manage it. I really don't. I mean, the lap times you do alone, I can't even get near them on a single lap, let alone that you keep doing it lap after lap, and that's a steady pace. Oh, there we go, we got an Audi that's
driving through walls.
Yeah, driving through the track and the wall.
Daniel Hacker, up a tent.
Oh, here we go. Oh,
although he's very wobbly on our screens.
Oh, there we go. Oh, we've got Mr. Hacker. Is he going to... I think I put him on pole, didn't I? Did he? Come on.
No.
Come on, Mr. Hacker.
Hacker.
yeah. He's just power sliding this.
Oh,
you're watching this.
A bit of a cut though.
Yeah, don't worry about that. That never happens.
Come on. Yeah, he's really sliding all over the place on the limit.
He's on the limit of this. This is a casting lap, this is.
So it's a slow lap? Ooh.
Oh, that was... God, dear. You know, he notices he comes away with his stuff, Carlson, but he's nowhere near your times, is he?
No.
Cross, it's a shame he'd have a job to beat you in a Formula 1 car.
Oh, good. I think everybody can beat me in a Formula 1 car. I'm so bad at Formula racing.
No, oh, cool, right, you got to join all the leagues I'm in, then. I might be able to beat you, woohoo! I can say that I'll beat Carsten without the aid of a stick. Come on, where's the sector? Is he still up? It's got to be around somewhere, isn't it? I think he's past it. Let's have a look on my map. Where is he on track?
What do you think of the paint of the car?
Yeah, I like it. I think it's cool. My map's no good. Oh, there he is. He's in the last sector. Yeah, we missed the sector update then. What was his last sector time?
I think, no, this won't be a fast time. Because under the Audi... under the Audi bridge, you have to have a 7.11. Then it will be the pole lap.
He's 1.4 seconds up.
1.4 or quicker.
Come on!
No, what?
He's 1.4 up! How's he found that? Come on!
Engine blow up or something. As he got pole by 0.3 of a second.
Come on!
Excuse me, I'll commit suicide for a second.
Yes, he's done.
For
he's
a second.
Done a 7.56.5. Come
explosion.
On.
Unreal. Marius Berg has committed suicide.
I can't believe he's for pole position.
Now I'm really depressed.
That's some lap, that is.
That's
Jesus
unbelievable.
Christ, that's an insane lap. So what have we got remaining?
Marius ain't
we've
going
got...
out.
We've got 9.5 minutes remaining. So, can Marius beat that?
We've nope, he's not going to.
Yeah,
I
yeah.
I hope so. Yeah. Why is he so
Daniel...
fast and why am I so slow? What's going on? Something is wrong here, definitely.
Yeah, I've got my man on pole position, which Shane means I'll beat him. War prediction.
Oh, God. He could be done for cutting, though. Could be done for cutting.
No, we can't.
I hope he isn't, but...
I'll bang him a thousand euros.
You'll pay him.
I got down to the TeamSpeak channel of us and ask him which cheat he uses. See you.
Bye. Good luck for tomorrow.
Bye.
Thanks.
Ram hack for the win.
What a bloody lap that was.
Marius ain't going out for another lap. Replace out there, yes he is. Not sure, oh he's on the grass. So, I'm not expecting this to be as quick as the top two, as they're both basically aliens at the moment.
This is going to be an interesting race then. Because we know what Marius is like at the start of races. He doesn't know what drive conservative means.
It's like he's really on the limit. Pushing as hard as he can. Just to find that little bit of time.
Yeah, certainly take your hat off to anyone that can do monster times around this track. I mean, I know the track like me back of me hand, but... to be running...
Oh!
7.7.
He's quicker.
Yeah, it's only 7,000ths though, isn't it? That's a lock-up which is just done there.
It seems like the more sideways you go, the quicker.
You got Daniel for second, I think. Unless it's Mr. Hacker.
And Marius for third.
Yeah. So,
I could be bang on.
I've got Mr. Scorfenza for third, so I'll still beat you, because I've got my man on pole.
Oh, yeah. Damn it.
Oh, he's gone. That's it. Game over. As I used to say on police camera action, he's crashed. Oh, dear. This is, I don't think anyone else has got any time to get out now, have they? What are we looking at? Times. We've got 6 minutes remaining, so it's only those on a lap at the minute that have got time to finish. So, we've got Thomas's out there. He's in seventh. Who else have we got? Let's quick. We've got Robin Haas. He's out there. Kevin, he's quick, and he's out there. He's in ninth. And there we go, we've got Rico's just jumped to 14th position. So it's all kicking off. I think Mr. Scorfenza, though, I think he can get another shot at this. Because even though the quali will...
If he minds his tyres, he could save them for next lap.
It's on the server set up to enable those that start the lap at the drop of the flag to finish it. So there's... Although it says 5 minutes remaining, that's actually not the case as such. If he can cross the line, he should get the next lap. It's like you say, it's if he's got the tyres and the fuel.
He will get an extra lap.
He must have the tyres and fuel, because why would he carry on going round? You'd just escape back to the pits if you didn't have it in there. No point driving around for the sake of driving. You're watching prove me wrong now.
That's all
that happens to me. How many viewers have we got? Just out of interest.
I think nearly 40. We've had about 37 for most of the night, so.
Well, nicely done.
Not bad, really.
That's beating our PB.
Well, for qualifying anyways, hopefully we'll have at least 100 and something for the main race tomorrow.
Yeah, well, we need to get rid of Lutz and our German colleagues because they pinch all of our listeners.
Yep.
So, what we'll say is Lutz can join us and then we'll win.
I think we need to hire Simon
exactly.
Smith.
We had Simon Smith in the last time we did the ring, and Liam Jenkins at midnight, and for 2 hours it was somewhat of a carry-on. me and Simon are never a good combination in the commentating booth for actual commentating. It tends to get out of hand with the innuendos. The first time was 12 Hours of Le Mans, and there's you've probably heard of them, the Scrotian brothers, and... the name came up and that was it. The innuendo started and he was going, you know, he's got his scrotum up against the wall and oh dear, it was just for like 2 hours all these dodgy innuendos in there. I mean, Oscar Hardwick was in on it as well and it was, oh dear, I've never laughed so hard and my jaw was killing me after that. That was whilst racing as well. 3 minutes till the timing shuts, but sort of said he should. Well, I don't think he's going to make it back in 3 minutes at the speed he's doing. He needs to speed up a bit there.
Yeah, very slow.
Yeah, no, we need more English teams in the league, what we need. Because I think it's what 90-odd% of them are German speaking, so. And I think quite a few of those can't understand English, and being as I speak borderline English, it makes it even harder.
Well, hopefully there should
be... I try speak English.
Hopefully there should be more teams out there that are non-German, should I say. come into the league, like Phoenix Motorsports. They're planning to come over. Ex RDLMS winners. They used to be called Atlantic Racing, but now they've changed their name to Phoenix.
Oh, they'll be on their way. Well.
They will be on their way for the Le Mans. And also Portugal Racing, they will be on their way as well with Andre Martins, which you guys should know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yep.
They have plans coming to do the 24 Hours of Le Mans, so...
In LMP1?
Yes, actually. Yeah, they are...
Oh, makes my life harder.
it makes my life much harder as well, because I've got to deal with really fast guys. At least I'm capable of keeping up with them. But yeah, they're really a strong team. Of course, they've done the last couple of Le Mans races. We've been on the podiums so far. All 24 hours. So yeah, a strong team might be coming into simracing.org in the future.
Cool. And we've got 1 minute 30 seconds remaining. Is he going to stay out? He did prove me wrong. He's gone to the pit.
Look who's out on track.
It's Mr. Marius Burtz going for it, so this is our chance. This is our last dial lap.
Come on.
Marius going to claim his P1 back. Although Shane's only got him down for third. Yeah, see, I'll still beat
him. I hope he gets pole.
I'll still beat
1.7 off in first sector.
Ooh. Got to find a lot of time through the second and last sector.
Because you predicted Marius for being third. And I predicted Mr. Hacker for being pole.
Yeah.
So even if Marius takes pole, I'll still beat you. Because it pushes Daniel down to second, whereas you've still got Marius for third. I'm guaranteed victory.
My God.
That's 50p you owe me. That's to go with the other 50p you owe me, so I'm up to a full pound now.
Damn it.
So it turns out this Friday was worth it in the end. Burnt myself a quid.
It was indeed.
It'll cost you more than that, because it'll cost you, 4 or 5 euros to send it. So then, Mr. Burt, what are you doing?
Yeah, so...
I'm
watching Marius Burtz and getting ready to pack my bag and change place. And yeah, so I mightn't even get to see the end of this lap. Hopefully I will, but hey. Just remind everyone, we go live tomorrow about, I said, 10 to 1. Give everyone a quick review of the race and what we're planning to do. Race starts around 2 o'clock, so make sure you tune in. We will give links on our Facebook page, Facebook.
Because qualifying is unofficial.
Facebook.com.
Due to having to be reviewed for corner cuts, and that'll be done through the wee hours by the organisation, and they'll launch the official results, which we'll give to you prior to the race. So if you join us about 1:30, and we'll give you the ins and outs and ups and downs. Come on, is there a split time and not working or something?
Round.
Nothing's happening. Come on.
Big splits. It's coming up in about a minute.
Are we up or are we down, Mr. Marius? Come on.
Let's go on board with him for a little bit of the lap. Is he pushing pretty hard?
It's got a nice balance in the car, I'll give him that. It's another one that's got a stupendous setup. Oh, he's down. He ain't going to pull that back, surely. 2.5 seconds to find in the last sector, which will be, best part of 3 minutes long, but I think there's still a big ask to find 2.5 seconds, but you never know, this is Marius Burtz.
Nah, it's impossible. If he gets it, that's just not human.
He needs about 100 more boosts to be able to get pole, but it doesn't work for now.
Because he's his original time behind, he's 3 temps down off the time as it stands. So
here comes Big Jump.
He's not even going to meet his PB by the looks of it.
Not even near.
Yeah, and it looks like that's game, that's set, it? And match. Because it's, let's say about NOS or something like that. He's going to need to find a small miracle to get pole position, being that down now. He's basically, he's got under a minute to cross the line from where he is, that ain't doable. And I'm getting 0 FPS, that's better, it's jumped to 15. Shane's nicked my internet again. Top three for you is Daniel Hacker, Marius Burt, and Daniel Scorfenza is your top three finishers, but that's unofficial results. So we will, like I say, give you the official results tomorrow before the race. What's this that Carson's sending me? Let's have a look.
And also, we have the 10th place car, Kevin Mass, out on track. And what did you get?
Oh, I'll have to share it with you, hang on.
There we go, 3.5 off.
Now, I used to look at that. It's, Carsten sending me things. Yeah, so, well done to all the, runners and riders. And that is them. Hello. Good, isn't it?
That's weird.
Don't worry, I'll find a lot more disgusting links than that.
Remember, there's children watching. Shane's not 18 yet.
Oh god, Shane, we might have to kick you now. There's 18s and over only.
Sorry. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, oh. Once it gets to the 9 o'clock watershed, you've got to go to bed. Then again, though, in all honesty, Shane doesn't seem to matter mind what the time is. Really. He's normally coming out with blasphemy at any time of the day. And then realises he says it, and what city comes out, oh, I said sheep.
Well... Sheet.
Yeah.
I need to go sheet.
But that's us for this evening's antics.
Well, so, not quite yet. As with Thomas Packer out on track.
We've got a couple coming over the line, but I can't see anything. Looking at these, there's no one lighting up the what's-its yet. We've got Mark Park, I think he is. Or Merck Perk, I don't actually know how to pronounce his name, so I apologise for that. He'll be the last man to cross the line. He's just coming down the big long back straight. In position 11, I do believe that is. So
Thomas Parker parks it up.
Go to position 11, my buttons have gone up the teapot again.
Teapot, there we go, coming across the line now.
And that's the last man to cross the line in 11th position. So, yep, that's it. Qualifying is finished. So, we will bid you farewell, and we will speak to you tomorrow from half past one UK time, half past two Central European time. You can join myself and Shane then, and also our German colleagues will be running a stream as well. So we thank you very much for watching, and we'll speak to you tomorrow.